How often do you find yourself wishing you had a highly portable laptop with you while you were traveling? For me, it's happened quite a few times. But laptops are generally quite bulky and annoying to carry around, and the ultralight notebooks, like the MacBook and the LG Gram, will cost you quite a few pretty pennies. So, let's take a look at how I somewhat solved this problem, at least in my case. I can generally do most of my internet surfing, like watching YouTube videos and Twitch live streams, from my phone. What really sucks about phones in my opinion, however, is the typing experience. Going from a full layout Cherry MX Blue mechanical keyboard to typing on a touchscreen with my thumbs is not a pleasant switch. That's why typing up scripts for videos is quite a pain while away from home. For this reason, I decided to go ahead and do my best to hack my phone into a makeshift laptop. Sadly, the vast majority of non-flagship phones, including my Samsung Galaxy J5 2016 16GB edition, if you're wondering, use a micro USB type B port, which is quite awkward because not many other electronics feature that. Introducing our savior, the USB OTG or USB on the go cable. To be fair, there's nothing that special about it. It's just an adapter that turns your sucky micro USB type B into a shiny full-size USB type A port. Plug this thing into your phone and bam, you've just opened your mobile device up to a whole world of PC peripherals. And you'll be surprised by how many of them are actually supported by your phone. My first choice was to plug in a keyboard and start typing away, but that's not all you can do. You can plug in almost any USB capable device. That includes thumb drives, keyboards, mice, SD card readers, gaming controllers, and even external hard drive enclosures, if they have another source from which to draw power. So that all seems nice and dandy, but what are the limitations? First of all, let's get the obvious one out of the way. You're not on a PC, you're not on a Mac, so you are limited by the capabilities of apps. Besides that, attaching an external device will lower your battery life, which is to be expected. Moreover, the small screen makes it hard to make out things such as small text from a distance while typing, so having good visions is a plus. Or, you know, glasses. But these are all minor complaints when you think that you are, after all, trying to use a small handheld device as a full-blown desktop computer or laptop. But even if you decide that the pros outweigh the cons, there is one last obstacle in your way. Our good old friend, compatibility. You see, not all phones support USB OTG. Most of them do, but not all of them. So before heading out and buying a cable, you have to do a bit of research and find out whether your particular phone does or doesn't offer support for this technology. If you're an Android, you can download USB OTG Checker from the Google Play Store and find it out easily. I'll leave a link in the description. If you are one of the three people using a Windows phone, then you can follow this link in the description to a Microsoft article that will show you how to find out if your phone supports OTG. And if you happen to be using an iPhone, which many people are, I have bad news for you. As with many other things, Apple has toyed around with their support for this technology, so the answer to the question, do iPhones support USB OTG, is, well, kinda? You see, no matter how many places I looked in, there were always people saying yes and people saying no. It does seem like you can get some wonky support for it with certain apps and using certain USB devices, but it's definitely not as seamless as Android and Windows Phone. So, it's conclusion time. Is this method worth? Yes, definitely. It lets you use your phone more effectively, and as a matter of fact, the script for this entire video was typed out on a HyperX alloy backlit mechanical keyboard, which I have previously reviewed, attached to a Samsung Galaxy J5 2016. Will this replace a laptop? Obviously not, but it will do in a pinch, letting you get a lot more functionality out of a phone or tablet. So, I really do hope you enjoyed this video, and if you want to see more, you can click on the right to watch my latest video, or on the left to watch a random video, or just click the round channel icon in the middle to subscribe. And as always, this has been Vlad from Goodsauce Tech, and I'll catch you in the next one. Take care, bye bye.